premio Polla de Potrillos, Grupo 1 en la escala internacional, Copa Red Pagos. Hace correr por el lado interior el número 1, el Boco. Lo sigue el número 4, Invasor. Tercera ubicación por el lado exterior, el número 6, Potrilor. Cuarto, ganando posiciones por el lado interior, el número 3, Percal. Más atrás, viene avanzando el número 10, Potri Peñarol. A medio cuerpo, ganando posiciones por el medio, el número 9, Story. Cuerpo y cuarto, más atrás, el número 12, Imparcial, 22.89, los primeros 400. El 1, el Boco, lidera con tres cuartos cuerpo de ventaja. Lo sigue el número 4, Invasor. Tercero, el número 3, Percal. Cuarto, abierto, el número 10, Potri Peñarol. Quinto, por el medio, el número 9, Story. Cuerpo y cuarto, más atrás, se viene desempeñando el número 6, Potrilor. Cuerpo y cuarto, ganando posiciones por el lado interior. Lo viene haciendo el número 5, Rienzo, mitad de codo. El 1, el Boco, cubre los primeros 800 en 45.96. Mantiene tres cuartos cuerpo de ventaja abierto. Se filtra por el lado interior, busca el punto número 3, Percal. Tercero, expectante, el número 4, Invasor. Cuarto, ubicación abierto, el número 10, Potri Peñarol. Ingresan a la recta final. Faltando 500 metros para el disco. El número 3, Percal, mantiene ventaja, lo sigue por el lado. El número 4, Invasor, que va en busca del puntero. Ha abierto la serie, el número 10, Potri Peñarol. 1-11-79, los primeros 1200. Por el medio, Invasor estira ventaja, se va quedando el número 3, Percal. Ha abierto la serie, el número 10, Potri Peñarol. El adelante del número 4, Invasor, mantiene tres cuartos cuerpo de ventaja. Lo sigue el número 10, Potri Peñarol. Tercero abierto, el número 11, va Coquín. El 4, Invasor, estira ventajas y varios cuerpos de ventaja. Pocos metros para el disco, orejeando el 4 Invasor, gana la Polla de Potrillo, Grupo 1.
Largaron el Gran Premio Copa Caliente. Sale por el lado estudio número 6, Big Back Fist. Un cuerpo de ventaja lo sigue el número 3, Invasor. Tercera ubicación, el número 1, Vasco King. Cuarto por el lado estudio, el 4, Potri Flash. Quinto viene accionando el número 5, Mete Mumullo. Cierra la marcha el competidor número 8, Dandy Oriental. Ingresaron a la recta opuesta. Últimos 1500 metros de la prueba, primeros 400 en 24.86. Lidera el número 6, Big Back Fist. Cuerpo de ventaja lo sigue el número 3, Invasor. Tercero, un cuerpo y cuarto junto a las tablas, el número 1, Vasco King. Cuarto al pescuezo por el lado, estudio el número 4, Potri Flash. Dos cuerpos más atrás, el número 5, Mete Mumullo. Cierra mancha al pescuezo por el lado exterior, el número 8, Dandy Oriental. 800 en 48.83. El 6, Big Buffis, mantiene cuerpo de ventaja, lo sigue el participante número 3, Invasor. Por el lado interior, a tres cuartos de cuerpo, el número 1. Largaron el Gran Premio Copa Caliente. Sale por el lado estudio el número 6, Big Back Fist. Un cuerpo de ventaja lo sigue el número 3, Invasor. Tercera ubicación, el número 1, Vasco King. Cuarto por el lado estudio el 4, Potri Flash. Quinto viene accionando el número 5, Mete Mumullo. Cierra la marcha el competidor número 8, Dandy Oriental. Ingresaron a la recta opuesta. Últimos 1500 metros de la prueba, primeros 400 en 24.86. Lidera el número 6, Big Back Fist. Cuerpo de ventaja lo sigue el número 3, Invasor. Tercero, un cuerpo y cuarto junto a las tablas. Largaron el Gran Premio Nacional, Grupo 1 en la escala internacional, Copa Uruguay Natural. Sale por el lado exterior a sacar ventajas el competidor 2 a Boderriz. Lo sigue por lo interior el 4 Tamanaco GG. Tercera ubicación, por el medio viene avanzando el competidor número 6, Invasor. Lidera el 2 a Boderriz buscando el lado interior con tres cuerpos de ventaja. Primeros 400 en 24.15, cuando cruza la sentencia por primera vez, lo sigue el número 1, Contrafuego. Tercera ubicación, Invasor. Cuarto, venciendo por el lado interior, Tamanaco GG. Quinta ubicación por el lado exterior, avanzando el 8, Dandy Oriental, en el codo del ferrocarril. Lidera el 2A, voz de Riz. Dos cuerpos y cuarto de ventaja lo sigue el número 1, Contrafuego. Tercera ubicación por el lado del número 6, Invasor. Cuarto al pescuezo por el lado del número 4, Tamanaco GG. Quinto ganando posiciones por el lado del número 8, Dandy Oriental. Ingresa a la recta opuesta. Van a la última milla de la competencia. Primeros 800 en 49,86. El 2A, voz de Riz. Aumentó a cuatro cuerpos la ventaja, lo sigue el número 1, Contrafuego. Se filtra junto a los palos, pasando a la segunda ubicación, el número 6, Invasor. Cuarto lo viene haciendo por el lado interior del 4, Tamanaco GG. Por el lado exterior, el número 8, Dandy Oriental, ganando posiciones por el medio, el número 5, Potri Flash. Dos cuerpos y cuarto, el número 2, Rienzo a medio cuerpo por el lado exterior, el número 7, La Señora. 1:15:32, los primeros 1.200. Lidera el 2A, voz de Riz. Dos cuerpos y tres cuartos, lo sigue el número 6, Invasor. Tercero del pescuezo adentro, el 4, Tamanaco GG. Cuarta ubicación por el lado exterior en línea. El 8, Dandy Oriental por el lado exterior, junto con el número 5, Potri Flash. Dos cuerpos y cuarto, el número 2, Rienzo. A medio cuerpo, La Señora. A medio cuerpo por el lado exterior viene avanzando el 1, Contrafuego. Tres cuartos de cuerpo por el medio, Shoot Dancer. 1:40:10, la primera milla, se acortan las distancias. El 2A, voz de Riz, mantiene medio cuerpo ventaja, ganando posiciones en busca del puntero del número 6, Invasor. Al pescuezo del número 8, Dandy Oriental. Cuarto expectante por el medio, el 5, Potri Flash. Mejorando por el medio, el 2, Rienzo. Ingresan a la recta final, faltando 500 metros para el disco. Por el lado interior, el número 6, Invasor. Lo sigue el 5, Potri Flash, que va en busca del puntero. Abierta La Señora. 2:06:35, los primeros 2 kilómetros. El 6, Invasor. Medio cuerpo de ventaja. Lo sigue el 5, Potri Flash. Tercera ubicación, el 7, La Señora. 250 metros finales. El 6, Invasor. Vuelve a estirar. Tres cuerpos de ventaja. Lo sigue Potri Flash. 120 metros finales. Invicto. Triple colorado el 6, Invasor, y cruzaron el disco.
Pimlico Special.
No.
All in.
No.
And they're off in the Pimlico Special. Argentinian Invasor out well, but Wandering Boy is expecting to show early speed. So it's Wandering Boy coming to a narrow lead. Three quarters of a length from Invasor second. West Virginia to the inside and Harlington racing deep out as they pass us now. And last of all is We Can See. So headed to that first turn, Wandering Boy and Javier Castellano leading it by three quarters of a length. But Ramon Dominguez and Invasor, the Argentinian, right in there in second spot as they round the turn. The outside is Harlington in third and West Virginia down to the fence in fourth, just 2.5 off the lead, and We Can Seek trailing the field. The opening quarter, 24 flat, so it looks like it's going to be a dead even pace here for Wandering Boy, who takes him up the back stretch with 6 furlongs to go. Wandering Boy, 3 quarters of a length. Invasor gets a nudge to go on from the second spot. Harlington continues wide in third, and fourth is West Virginia, another 2 lengths back, and We Can Seek has now dropped about 6 lengths off the front running Wandering Boy. The pace has picked up, but only slightly for Wandering Boy, comfortable with no challenge yet. Invasor still chasing on the outside. West Virginia hustle along down to the fence. Harlington on the outside. And last of all is We Can Seek. Pretty much no change around the far turn. And Wandering Boy is going to try to sprint home now with 3/8 to go. Wandering Boy. Invasor chasing on. Harlington, West Virginia is riding the fence. And West Virginia is coming with a run from second. West Virginia into second. But Wandering Boy turns for home. Hustled at the quarter pole by a length and 3/4 from West Virginia. Invasor in third. And Harlington fourth, and We Can Seek riding the fence. They're at the 360s. Wandering Boy doing just that, wandering a bit toward the center of the track. Invasor shoulder to shoulder now with West Virginia down to the inside. Invasor's coming back for more. Invasor down to the inside. Wandering Boy. Invasor down to the inside with a 16th of a mile left to come. Ramon Dominguez and Invasor, the Argentinian invasion in the Pimlico Special. Wandering Boy was second, and West Virginia was third.
I told you about the four horse!
Invasor or Invasor, we don't care what he's called. He wasn't dead last. Kieran McLaughlin lied to us. He was up closer. Looked like the race was over. It looked like a full-on win for Wandering Boy, wire to wire, but a great ride cutting inside.
Now, watch this. As he came down the wire, Invasor came over on the number 2 West Virginia and interfered with Todd Pletcher's horse at about the 16th pole, or maybe between the 8th and 16th poles. If we get another look at it.
I saw nothing like that.
You saw nothing like that.
And they're off.
Wilco breaks well in Wild Desert there toward the inside. Noble Causeway up close today, and Invasor in the far outside. Noble Causeway has taken the initiative. Noble Causeway out for that lead. Wild Desert on the inside and between horses is Wilco. The bend into the backstretch has Noble Causeway in front. The blinkered Wilco right up and down the pace today. And Invasor just outside the lead and running along in third. Wild Desert is fourth. Tap Day fifth on the outside. And then it's Rathor and Stretch Running. And Dromedo's Hero is the trailer. Six lengths from his stablemate, Noble Causeway. 24-1 was that sensible opening quarter here in the Suburban. So down the backstretch, Noble Causeway. Here comes Wilco right up to his neck as they continue with six furlongs to go here. Invasor. Invasor, the favorite, runs in third position. And then it's Wild Desert who's in between horses. And Dromedas Hero is only two lengths from the lead with five furlongs to go. Tap Day and Rather into the far turn, the half in 47 and 3/5 seconds. Noble Causeway and Wilco knocking heads with a half mile to go. Noble Causeway narrow lead. Wilco's moving right with him willingly. A length and a half. Invasor is called on for run. Invasor looms just a length behind the leaders with three furlongs to go. Andromeda's Hero asks for his best. He's coming through an opening toward the inside fourth. Then Rather on the outside. Wild Desert in between those horses as the field turns for home. Here's Invasor on the outside, galloping to the lead. Fernando Haro's looking around for competition, extremely confident. Wild Desert has moved to second. Noble Causeway is third. Andromeda's Hero is fourth. Now Haro says go with Invasor, and they are impressive. They are awesome. Invasor has won the Suburban by four resounding lengths over Wild Desert.
Ninth tap, third on the inside. Flower Alley is fourth. And Invasor, Fernando Haro moves him through an opening there between Flower Alley and Premium Tap. Survivalist is six lengths from the front and six. Sun King to his inside. Another five back to Longshot Week and Seek in West Virginia. The half went in 47 and 1/5 seconds. Siphon City and Wandering Boy still 1-2 into the fire turn. Premium Tap under a ride third. In between horses, Invasor. And just to his outside is rival Flower Alley. And it's another two lengths back. And Sun King is called on for one with three furlongs to go. Three quarters in 11 and one, and they're coming to the top of the stretch. And it's Wandering Boy in an all-out drive to wrest that lead away from Siphon City. Invasor is right there, and now he takes to the outside. Flower Alley in a full-out drive on the far outside. Sun King, Premium Tap has come through an opening toward the rail. We Can Seek is a long shot looking for a way through. There's one furlong to go in the Whitney here. Sun King on the outside, and Invasor who digs down. Invasor and Sun King, those two coming to the line together in a pitch battle. It's Invasor and Sun King, and at the wire, it's a head bob that may have gone to Invasor. It was desperately close. Sun King was right there with him. West Virginia came on to be third, and We Can Seek was fourth in a thrilling renewal of the Whitney. From Siphon City, Invasor is right there, and now he takes to the outside. Flower Alley in a full-out drive on the far outside. Sun King, Premium Tap has come through an opening toward the rail. We Can Seek is a long shot looking for a way through. There's one furlong to go in the Whitney here. Sun King on the outside, and Invasor who digs down. Invasor and Sun King, those two coming to the line together in a pitch battle. It's Invasor and Sun King, and at the wire, it's a head bob that may have gone to Invasor. It was desperately close. Sun King was right there with him. West Virginia came on to be third, and We Can Seek was fourth.
Gates closed, and they're all set. There's the roar from the Churchill Downs crowd as the Breeders' Cup Classic feels set on their way, and Lawyer Ron in the white in the middle immediately sprints to the lead. Lava Man is right there. Bernardini came away beautiful, and Brother Derek's taken a strong hold down at the rail. Alongside of him comes Premium Tap. There couldn't be much more speed on early here on the outside. Here's Flower Alley keeping them on as Bernardini's pedaled down in the sixth spot now, being followed by George Washington of the rail, six off the leaders. Invasor is racing alongside of Suave. They're a good eight lengths off the lead now. then back to Sun King. Along the inside of those two, we have David Jr. scraping the paint, then back to Perfect Drift, and Giacomo is the trailer. Giacomo 15 off the leader. Onto the backstretch they go, and Brother Derek virtually sprinting out here. He's setting up fast pace, a length and a half to Lawyer Ron. Lava Man is in third. Down at the rail, Premium Tap in the gold colors. Bernardini is back in fifth now, and Bernardini might be being asked to pick it up from here. Bernardini is six lengths off the leader, is going to have to go wide now. George Washington is coming through inside of him, then David Jr. Invasor tries to get up closer, he's seven off the leaders. Then Suave, Sun Ken behind that, Perfect Drift, and Giacomo continues to trail. Less than a half mile to go, Brother Derek is the leader. There's Lawyer Ron chasing him in second. Now Bernardini has suddenly kicked it in. It looked like he might be battling, but Bernardini with a magnificent rush on the outside in the white sleeves, and Bernardini strikes the front in the Classic. Brother Derek running a huge one to his inside. In behind those two now, Invasor's coming home gamely as well down the center. Bernardini, Invasor's coming with a good run down the center of the track. Brother Derek tries to battle back along the inside, but Invasor, Bernardini, Invasor, Invasor and Bernardini in a thriller, but Invasor's got his measure. And Invasor, the Argentinian bred, Uruguayan raced, Invasor has won the Classic. Second was Bernardini, Premium Tap running on third. Giacomo came from dead last to finish fourth, just ahead of Brother Derek.
18-1, bar three, right out to Bullish Luck at 40-1.
He's three quarters of the way in, he's all the way in. The gator snapshot, and they are set and ready to run. Racing in the Dubai World Cup. Premium Tap and 40 Licks both a little slow to go, and Candidate not showing a great deal of speed. Japan's Vermilion began very quickly. Bullish Luck began well, and Invasor, and there is Premium Tap. Premium Tap is now bursting out of the pack and running to the lead. Vermilion is second at the 1700 meters mark. 40 Licks moves around the outside to chase Premium Tap, and Bullish Luck will settle fourth. A half length away, Invasor traveling a little deep. Candidate is second last, and Discreet Cat on the fence, ahead away at the tail of the field as they go past the 1400 meters mark. Premium Tap the leader by a half length. 40 Licks is second. A length and a half to Bullish Luck, who's third and covering a little extra ground, followed by Invasor, who's now taking closer order, moving up three deep. He's within a length and a half of the pace. Vermilion on the rail. Candidate is second last, and Discreet Cat is a length away, last of the seven, as they go past the 1,000 metres mark. Premium Tap showing the way down the side of the track. Invasor has now gone up to second. He's a half length off the lead. 40 Licks is third as they travel down the side. Candidate is wide going forward. Vermilion is on the fence coming to the bend. Frankie has Discreet Cat on the outside, and Bullish Luck now drops back to the tail when heads are turned for home, and they look at a big, big prize. Premium Tap in front. Invasor on the outside is going up to close the gap. They're two and a half lengths clear of Bullish Luck, who's gone to third. Then Vermilion. Discreet Cat's on the outside. He's under the whip. Invasor lays it down to Premium Tap. 220 meters left to go. Invasor puts his head in front. Premium Tap battles back. They're a mile in front. Invasor, Premium Tap, they're having a battle. Invasor is now going home the better, and Invasor is too good. He drew away. He won by two lengths to Premium Tap. Bullish Luck, eight lengths away running third. Then came Vermilion, 40 Licks, Candidate, and Discreet Cat was last at the seven in the 2007 Dubai World Cup.
Racing welcomes a new star, the highest rated horse in the world, ridden by one of the most inexperienced. Really wouldn't have believed you.
We're a couple of good judges,
absolutely,
aren't we?
Well, I can't think it suited Discreet Cat being at the back. Invasor was the one that had track position. I expected the two to be the other way around. But he did take his time to get past Premium Tap, who, full marks to him, he just didn't lie down.
Well, 19-year-old Fernando Jara.